Hello everyone, warm greetings. Welcome to another video by me. My name is Himanshu Shukla, and in today's video we are going to see the orientation for the ethics full course which we have announced recently. So this will be a very short video and a crisp video where we will discuss the contours of ethics and its preparation related to ethics, and also the features of the course which we have announced and many things. So what are we going to discuss in today's video is about the ethics full course. So today we will be discussing about how important ethics paper is in getting top 100 rank. Then in this video we will see why this course has been launched and what is the motive of this course, what we are going to see. Next we will discuss about who should opt for this course, like who should opt for this course 2021 2022. We'll discuss that. And then we are going to discuss about the features of this course. Okay. So starting with the first topic, that is the how important ethics paper is in getting top 100 rank. So before that, let me tell you that for sure all of us, whosoever prepares for civil services, we always aspire to get this top 100 rank in the merit list. And why to get top 100 rank, or for that matter why to be in top? Because all of us want to become IAS officers, and we know that the IAS seat is very limited. Last to last year in 2018, it got closed at 93 rank only. 93rd rank, the people from 94th onwards, they couldn't get that. Before that in 2017, the seat was extended to 106 rank. So a lot of combinations are there which when you will appear for the exam, you will get to know when you will reach that level. So top 100 rank is not that easy, because we have to balance each and everything. And if we have to get top 100 rank, then not only we have to balance all the GS papers, optional and interview, we have to also work on essay and other related improvement we have to do. So there comes the role of ethics. GS4 becomes very crucial. Okay. So understanding that why and how ethics paper, how important ethics paper is, we will see, we will get to know about this importance with the help of the weightage in exam of the ethics paper, or the learning which we get from the ethics paper. So directly in mains examination, we have a paper, GS4 paper, where the whole, informally we called ethics, but GS4 is known as the GS4 paper is known as informally as ethics. So UPSC has divided the whole main syllabus in four parts, that is GS1, GS2, GS3, GS4. Then we have two optionals, and then we have one essay, and of course two qualifying papers. So nine papers are there. Out of that, 250 marks is given for has been allocated for GS paper 4, which is worth of 250 marks. So directly we have, and this paper is worth of 250 marks. Then next we have essay paper. When we write essay, we need lot of quotations, we need lot of validation material, we need lot of stories, anecdotes, ethical keywords, values, value system with respect to India, with respect to individual. So all those concepts, all those learning which the content which we develop in the ethics paper, that is in this paper, GS4 paper, directly we use it in essay paper. So essay paper also has a weightage of 250 marks. So here GS paper 4 and essay, they are linked. So every year UPSC has giving 8 topics in essay, and they have divided in such a manner that section A, they are asking philosophical papers, philosophical questions, philosophical topics they are giving. So if you are well prepared on, you have this good content for ethics, then those learnings, those content you can use for writing the philosophical essays. And with ethics, with the content of ethics, one dimension you can improve and increase in essay, or for that matter GS papers, GS 1, 2, 3. So what is the average marks or highest marks if we say in GS paper 1, 2 and 3, people are scoring somewhere between 110 to 120 marks. Okay, in GS3 people are scoring 130 as well. That is quite exceptional, but you have to go in that depth, and you have to prepare the value addition material, or for that matter your understanding, the examples, you have to substantiate it in such a manner, then only you can score 130 marks here in GS1, 2, 3. How about highest marks in GS4? In GS4, people are scoring somewhere between 120 to 160. Last year, people have scored, one girl, she has scored 165 marks. So can you see the variation? The difference is of 40 to 50 marks. And this 40 to 50 marks is sufficient enough to either push you for the rank or to not getting into the merit list, or for that matter, not qualifying for the interview as well. So why to risk? Why to take risk? And with this learning of ethics, GS4, those who have attended my economic survey video in 2018 and 2019, they know that there was a concept of behavioral economics or behavior aspect, behavioral units. So such concepts which we read in ethics will give us one or two dimension in GS 1, 2, 3 paper writing. So the average marks which we get, for example, out of 10, if we are scoring 4 or 5 marks, that will increase to 6 marks, because that will add unique addition or unique dimension to your answers. Okay? So this difference of 40 to 50 marks is too much. Next, directly the ethics preparation helps you in interview. How it helps you in interview? When we prepare for interview, then we know that when we prepare for ethics, for that matter, at the level of mains, the ethics preparation helps us in self-introspection. It helps us in analyzing ourselves. It helps us in analyzing different institutions. It helps us in becoming sensitive towards the needs of the people, towards having an approach of citizen-centric approach, or for that matter, whatever is happening in the surrounding, we become sensitive, because when we read, of course, we as a human are sensitive, but the content of ethics, or when we prepare properly, mind it, when we prepare properly, then we become more sensitive and we understand the people's problem from the ethical mindset, or from the mindset of whatever probity, integrity, such keywords, they help us in shaping our thought process. This is one addition, or the one way it helps us in interview. It shapes our personality. Another way how it helps, second dimension, how ethics preparation is helping you in interview. In ethics, those who know that UPSC has divided the paper into section A and section B. In section B, UPSC gives 6 to 7 questions, which are known as case studies. When we solve case studies, those who have watched my Analytica series, they know, you must have seen that how we decode the case studies and how we write them. So the stakeholder approach, or for that matter, decoding the needs, demands, and the problem-solving attitude, which we learn from the case studies, directly helps us in interview. And in interview, the board, the UPSC board, they give us a lot of situation reaction questions. A situation will be given to you, and you have to act accordingly. This is a situation, what will you do? This is a situation, what will you do? You just imagine you become IAS officer, analyze the problems of your district, 3 topmost problems, how you are going to solve that. So the preparation of the case study, or the approach which we study in the ethics paper, it helps us directly. So can you calculate? Can you quickly go through 250 marks here, 250 marks here, 500 marks? Okay, we are not counting the value addition which we will get in GS 1, 2, 3 by learning ethics. But this 40-50 marks weightage difference is there, and 275 marks in interview. I'm not saying that directly whatever you are reading in ethics, you will get, it will help directly, or whole interview marks you will get from ethics only, but the attitude, the approach, the problem-solving attitude, the stakeholder approach, or your sensitivity, the values like honesty, integrity, it helps us in reinforcing those values. Okay, so if you calculate, 500, and this 275. So approx 600 to 700 marks we get directly from, we get the help from learning GS paper 4 or ethics, whatever we learn the content. But again, it depends how we are learning. Okay? So that is another aspect. And you know that whosoever is becoming the topper, top 5 people who are scoring marks, they are getting around 1000 or 1100 marks, somewhere around 1160, like that. So just imagine if you are scoring with the help of ethics somewhere around 600 marks or 700 marks, don't you think that it is a value, it will add value to your rank? Yes, it will. But again, not only ethics is going to help, but yes, it is definitely going to help you in giving a value addition. Okay. Next, we are going to see, when we know the importance, then why do candidates score less? We know the importance, we know the worth, we know its weightage in the examination. Still people are scoring less. Then what is the reason behind that? People are scoring less because of the neglect and undue attention. The proper attention is not given to GS paper 4 or neglect that, okay, I can handle, chalta hai, manage kar lenge, all those approach. And also undue attention is given or over emphasis. We emphasize more on GS 1, 2, 3 and current affairs, optional. Sometimes we even ignore optional, we ignore essay preparation, we ignore ethics preparation. That's why we don't score much. Overconfidence, I can manage. When we go and see the previous year paper or the previous year question paper of ethics, UPSC has asked in 2015 that what is happiness? Yes, I can write happiness. What is anger? I can write anger. But they are generic questions, but you need to have a specialized preparation for such questions as well. So overconfidence is kills the curiosity or kills the learning. Not realizing the importance. Whatever in whatever importance we have analyzed or discussed in the previous slide, hardly people know its importance, that how it will contribute directly or indirectly in their preparation. But to know importance, first you need to learn ethics, or for that matter, any subject, okay? Then only you will realize the importance. Lack of practice, since we know that UPSC is asking what is anger, what are the values which this national education policy is focusing upon, we think that we can manage. So we don't practice. We rely on our GS knowledge. We rely on our personality in order to attempt this GS paper 4. We think that, okay, it's manageable. We have done sufficient practice in our GS 1, 2, 3, 4, so we can manage. So lack of practice is one important limiting factor for not scoring much good marks. Lack of exam orientation. Many times, many of my students, after giving interview also, or for that matter, writing multiple mains, they don't have this aptitude that how to write exam-oriented ethics answer. So it comes with time, but it needs practice. It comes with time, definitely, but it comes with having a good content, having good practice, then only you get this exam orientation, okay? Waste of time. We do a lot of wastage of time in choosing classes, or for that matter, choosing material, which material is good, which material is bad. So we'll waste a lot of time. We read a lot of topper's strategy, but every topper's strategy is unique, okay? And last moment preparation. We rely on the topper's material that, okay, this topper has uploaded this material, download it, we will read it. Or last moment preparation, we'll go and take the compilation from the market and we think that we can score well. No, because you have not imbibed those learnings. Falling prey to this market of notes or the random books. There are many books in the market which are not books actually, but they are guide, kunji. Those who are from North India, they would be understanding that. So they are not books actually, they are not books to empower you. So because of all these reasons, we score less. Okay, now why this course? So why this course has been launched at this point of time and why this course? So this course will help you in a streamlined preparation, in overcoming the limiting factors which we have discussed in the previous slide, or for that matter, when we have discussed the weightage and its importance. So it will help you in streamlining your preparation. And this course is asking you to give your only 5 hours in the weekend, 2.5 hours on Saturday, 2.5 hours on Sunday. So basically you are giving 5 hours in a week. So in a week, how many hours are there? If you multiply 24 hours by 7, you will get around, I guess, 168 hours. So out of 168 hours, you are just devoting 5 hours. So rest 163 hours you have for preparing your optional, preparing your prelim, devoting it for prelims preparation, or for that matter, your GS 1, 2, 3, CSAT, anything you want, you can devote for it, and for all the recreational activities as well. Since it is only a weekend course, which we are starting from the 14th of the August, so it will help the working professionals because most of the working professionals, they get time only on Saturday and Sunday, and that too only when they are preparing seriously. Okay, so it will help them there. It will, from the starting, you will, there will, there won't be any compromise on building content, or for that matter practice or test notes. There won't be any compromise. There will be hand holding from the very first day itself. So we are not going to compromise, and you will also not compromise on your preparation. Also, you won't have this feeling of guilt, because when you are preparing holistically, then you will be confident with the, for with respect to your preparation. So there won't be any guilt, and overall score will improve, because you are giving a small chunk of your time to ethics preparation. And over a period of time, we are starting this course on 14th August, and only on Saturday and Sunday we will finish it by first week of December. So overall score will improve, because you are giving, you are allocating time equally for all these subjects. And you know what is the topper's hallmark? Topper's hallmark is that they give their, they devote balanced time, or for that matter, their approach is balancing everything, not neglecting anything. And neglect here doesn't mean that we have to superficially touch everything. Here it means that preparing everything in depth, but preparing and devoting time for all the papers and all the stages. So that is the topper's hallmark. Okay. Now, who should take this course? So there is a lot of dilemma. Many of my students are approaching and they are saying that, sir, we are appearing for this prelims 2021, whether we should go ahead for this course or not. Again, it is your call. It depends how well prepared you are for prelims. UPSC has actually postponed the exam from May to October. And after October, again, we have mains in January 2022. So after prelims, you're not going to get a lot of time to prepare. Okay, so keep in mind that if you are well prepared for prelims, then go ahead, because this is only demanding 5 hours of your week, as we discussed in the previous slide. Rest 163 hours you have there for your other preparation. Post prelims, you won't get much time, so you have to devote your time. For 2022 people, yes, since you have started, it is a very good time, because if you start ethics preparation after December, then you will get stuck in the same cycle of from March onwards, you will stuck in this cycle of preparing for prelims. And this, by the time you realize the importance of ethics in late December, January or February, it will be very late, and you cannot afford it to prepare for next year after prelims. So this is the best time for you. Okay, what this course has in store for you. So quickly, we will discuss here about the features of this course, what we have in store for you. So here, the first feature is the weekend classes. As we have discussed, it is a weekend class of Saturday and Sunday, 2.5 hours each. So we are devoting only 2.5 hours. Next, we are focusing more on conceptual clarity. So the focus is on conceptual clarity. I will explain the whole concept, then after explaining the concept, I will give a lot of questions, which I have given the name thoughts to ponder. You have to think, you have to analyze your surrounding, you have to analyze yourself. So the first learning you are developing through this course is, after conceptual clarity, is through thoughts to ponder. So you are imbibing those learnings. You are relating the learnings in your surrounding at your own level. After this, handwritten manuscripts will be given, handwritten notes. So I'm calling it manuscript. So handwritten notes will be given for all the subunits which are there in the syllabus. So we have 7 units and approximately 32 subunits are there, topics are there. For every subtopic, handwritten notes will be provided to you, 1-page notes, which will help you in revision. So revision friendly notes will be given. Keywords. Keywords play a very important role, because many of my students say that, sir, I am lacking keywords. I end up writing a lot of sentences in the answer and I won't attract marks. Ethical jargons I'm missing. I'm ethical keywords I'm missing. And in this exercise, in this anxiety and fear, they end up collecting a lot of keywords. And 400, 500 keywords will be there. So we have to filter all those things. And after every concept, we will discuss. And I will empower you with the help of keywords which you can use in the exams directly. Different approaches for the case study in order not to make your case studies monotonous. So 7 case studies worth of 120 to 130 marks. You must have seen in Analytica video. So different approaches we will learn for the case studies. Practice questions will be given for every unit, subunit. So first learning is thoughts of ponder. Second learning is at practice question. Third, there will be test after every unit. Test per unit will be there. Okay. So three ways you are doing this practice. Also, the previous year question papers will be analyzed and discussed. Value addition material, wherever it is required, the value addition material in a PDF format will be provided to you. Maybe it will be directly or indirectly help in any particular concept or any new addition. So it will be given through that. Current affairs linkage. So there is a dilemma how to link current affairs, or dilemma, or you can say people don't know how to use the current affairs learning in the ethics answer. So I will empower you for that as well. For this whole duration, whatever this course will be there, we will see and understand how to collect the current affairs and use it in our answer writing. Test per unit will be there. Hand holding and mentorship. Yeah. So those who are in touch with me, many of my students are there in touch with me from last 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. So they know that if they are in touch with me, once a mentor, always a mentor, even after your selection. So this is not only till the duration of this course, till the time you get selected, or for that matter, even after that, my mentorship will be there with you. Okay. And other than these features, whatever we have mentioned here, we in the article you must have read that there is a special feature where our topper Kritika ma'am will be there, and she will be also guiding us through this course through various sessions, and she will also help us in enriching our answers. Okay, so yeah, this is it, and thank you so much for watching this video. And if you are planning, and still if you have any doubt, then read the article on the website. I have given my Telegram ID, and do approach me in case of any doubt. We are starting this course from 14th of August. See you in the class. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.